$1 million may sound like a lot of money, yet compared to the sheer difficulty and scale of this problem, it's a puny sum, the P versus NP problem. But what is the P versus NP problem? At its core, it poses a mind-twisting question. If it's easy to confirm a solution, is it equally simple to find that solution in the first place? Now, this might sound bewildering. Why is this considered the Mount Everest of unresolved puzzles in computer science? Let's set aside the jargon for a moment and have a little fun. How about a game? Imagine number Scrabble, you versus me. The goal is choose three numbers that add up to 15. The first to reach 15 wins. And if all numbers are chosen without hitting that magic 15, it's a draw. It's a pretty neat puzzle, right? But let's reframe this game into a 3x3 square, where each set of three numbers in a column, row, or diagonal adds up to 15. Now, how would you win this game? It's like tic-tac-toe, no? Just choose your three of numbers before your opponent. Now, here's the mind-blowing part. Many diverse games can be boiled down into the same fundamental structure. And this extends to beyond games, to numerous problems in computer science. They can all be distilled into one common problem. And we can employ a uniform strategy to solve this problem. And that strategy is what we call algorithms. Now, you see, a P problem is a problem that can be verified quickly and solved quickly. For example, let's say you're given a list of different activities. Next to each activity, you have a number from 1 to 10, determining the satisfaction level, 10 being the highest, obviously. Your task is to find the activity with the highest satisfaction level. Now, solving this is pretty easy, and it's easy to verify as well, no? An NP problem is a problem that can be verified quickly, but solving it takes much, much longer. Let's take your dietary choices, for example. Selecting foods that meet your nutritional needs while adhering to your dietary restriction can be quite hard and take a lot of time to do so. But once it's done, you can easily tell that it meets your requirements. How about another scenario I know many of us can relate to? Imagine a student facing a juggling act between homework, personal time, and extracurricular activities. They have to plan their week to manage stress and ensure all tasks are completed. In this scenario, verifying completed tasks is pretty easy. For instance, taking off finished homework or activities. However, the process of efficiently planning the week to ensure all tasks are completed and strike a balance between them while minimizing stress and maximizing your well-being can be quite complex. You see how it all connects now? To quote MIT complexity researcher Scott Aronson, if P were equal to NP, the world would be a profoundly different place than we'd assume it to be. There would be no special value in creative leaps, no fundamental gap between finding a solution and recognizing it once it's found. Everyone who could appreciate a symphony would be Mozart. Everyone who could follow a step-by-step argument would be Gauss. And everyone who could recognize a good investment strategy would be Warren Buffett. Suggesting that if P is equal to NP, everyone here or everyone around the world would possess extraordinary problem-solving skills, erasing the distinction between recognizing the solution and finding it in the first place. It implies a world where the genius and the skills behind great achievements, be it in music, mathematics, or finance, would no longer be extraordinary and universally attainable by everyone here. Now that you know what P and NP is, how does this relate to our mental well-being? You see, if you prove that P is equal to NP, the advancements in technology and problem-solving skills could streamline various approaches, reducing the mental burden associated with complex problem-solving. Individuals could benefit from these streamlined approaches to managing tasks, thereby freeing up mental space when managing intricate schedules and responsibilities. On the other hand, if P is proven not to be equal to NP, it could encourage a mindset that appreciates the complexity of certain problems. This understanding might lead to the development of adaptive strategies, creative thinking, and fostering mental resilience when tackling intricate challenges. Embracing these complex problems could empower individuals to handle difficulties with patience and innovative problem solving. Reducing the stress related to the pressure of immediate solutions. Now, P versus MP is a problem that refers to the very basics of all decision-making in life, as it just boils down to algorithms. Algorithms are just a series of steps to solve a problem. You finding your seat here could be considered an algorithm. Ultimately, P versus NP isn't just solving equations. It's a journey that simplifies complexities and sparks creative insights. As we delve into life's intricacies, let us remember the wisdom of Fight Club. The first rule of navigating complexity is, you do not talk about the struggle. The second rule is, you do not talk about the struggle. Find the balance, embrace your journey, and let the enigma of experience unfold. Thank you.